I come from the small town which is called Vukovar, and it's situated in the middle part of the River Danube. But this town has a big and very important history, because from the Middle Age until now it's the center of the whole region, and political and cultural and also in every other meaning. So in our museum we keep the old things and keep the history of this town. And in this situation I will tell you a little story about that, how was important the role of Vukovar Municipal Museum in restoring the memory of the town of Vukovar after war destruction in 1991. So our museum is situated on the right bank of the River Danube in Palace Elz, which belonged to German Elz family from middle of the 18th century until the end of the Second World War. In this Baroque and Classicistic style is situated our museum, and the last reconstruction and renovated happened in 2012 under very strong recommendation of Conservation Department of Ministry of Culture and Croatian Department of Restoration. In the January 2014, we opened our permanent exhibition in space of 3,500 square meters, and with 2,000 restored exhibits, we try to show the history of the town, of course, the history of whole region, that means from full history of the region and from the first documents about our town, which is dated in the beginning of 13th century. And of course, we want to show all this story, including the homeland war, of course, and today's situation when inhabitants of Vukovar live in very complex multinational society. But our museum was established 70 years ago in one of the Baroque buildings in the center of the town, and in a few years we make bigger our collections and of course make some exhibitions in ex-Grand Hotel and later Walker House for 20th century history, and of course later in the house where was born the first Croatian Nobel Prize winner, Lavoslav Ružička. All this collection were complete from 1966 in Elz Palace, where our museum was from that time until now. Our collections covered historical collections, then Bauer collection, which is the most beautiful collection Croatian artists, especially between a period between the two world wars. Then memorial of Nobel Prize winner Lavoslav Ružička, of course the ethnology collections and archaeological collection, which is the most popular finds from archaeological place 5 kilometers from Vukovar, which is called Vučedol. But 1991, Vukovar in Croatia was attacked from Yugoslav army and paramilitary soldiers from Serbia. The first attack happened in 25 August 1991. In 100 days, how we call the battle for Vukovar, or in 3 months, the whole town was completely destroyed. About 14,000 houses, all monuments, and of course all surroundings of Vukovar. But the most terrible things happened with the victims, of course, because Vukovar, after surrounding, was in situation that Croatian people must go in exile, because after occupation of our town, inhabitants of Vukovar were separated on Croats and Serbs, and Croats must leave the town. And from that time, from 1991 until or during the 7 years, at least 7 years, then 10 or more, they must live in so many different places all around Croatia. That means from Dubrovnik to Vinkovci, because they cannot come back in Vukovar for 7 years, all the time when Vukovar was occupied. It was a really terrible time because the people must leave their town. They lost the town completely, they lost their houses, they lost their friends, they lost every personal things, including in photo of family album. This terrible time, of course, has consequences for all the inhabitants of our town, and this is the time when the rule of Vukovar Municipal Museum began. Else Palace and Museum was also badly damaged. All our exhibitions, all our things was also inside this building. And as you see these photos, it was really a terrible time when all monuments and whole town was completely destroyed during the aggression on Vukovar. Also, our collections were also very badly damaged, and there was no possible to protect them. Most of them were collected and taken away from Vukovar to Novi Sad, but most of them, about 13%, is still missing. But this very big destruction make a very big problems when we come back and when we try to make a new collection, a new presentation, because we lost the very important part of our collections. But what was very important that we come back, because we must be in exile and spend 7 years in a very famous museum in Zagreb, which is called Nimara Museum, and the Ministry of Culture and other colleagues, we try to make plans for returning. It happened a few years later, exactly on 27 of 1987, and we start to live in the ruins of Castle Els and the ruins of Vukovar. Our collections were written back in 2001, and it was the beginning of restoring our collections and preparing for a new museum. But reconstruction of Els Castle started in 2008 under very strong input of conservation department, because for us and for all people from Vukovar was very important that the whole town and especially monuments of culture must be restored like it was before, because we want to be back in a town that we know, not in some other new town. And because of that, all this what's happened in the reconstruction of our monuments in whole town was to make the same face of our town like it was before. So Els Palace became the most important exhibit also in our permanent exhibition. Very beautiful halls are now for different kind of presentation or manifestation, and our museum collections show the history of the town, but it was very heavy to collect very many small pieces, maybe from other museums, maybe from the people who take these things with them, because our collections were so badly damaged that we must have so many colleagues from other museums to complete our collection and show them. But the most important was in our living in the ruins of Vukovar to make the possibility that returning people has a place where they can meet each other. So we asked so many artists from all over Croatia to come to Vukovar and start to make a cultural reconstruction of the town together with us. So we established so many different manifestations, exhibitions, festival of chamber music, festival of Advent celebration. So I can really say that thousands of people from all over Croatia come to Vukovar to enjoy with us and to prepare for this children's situation, that they cannot see the ruins around them, but that they can see a beautiful town, of course, in the future. This photo is very important for us because you can see the small shoes, but it is the right shoes of our children from kindergarten. Because it is important, we have a Borovo factory, shoe factory, but in the archaeological place Vucedol, we found this beautiful small shoes from stone, of course, and this is a symbolic way to show how the living it has his continuity from folk history until our days. But also, I want to say that our connection with the children was all the time very important, and that all and many manifestations that we do or workshops is connected with our children. It is because many of them was so young. Was so young when Vukovar was destroyed or were born somewhere in abroad, so they have not their memories. So, for us was very important to make all possibilities to give them chance to make connections with their roots, and then that they can teach about the history, about the present time, and that can enjoy in a beautiful life in Vukovar.
Thank you.
of funnels from Učedol is Učedol Dab. It symbolizes 5,000 years living in this region, and because of that, especially after the war, became a symbol of Vukovar. Because of that, we used that symbol and asked the children from kindergarten from all nationalities to come and be together in this form of this I would like to tell you something which is still a problem in Vukovar. After the war and after our returning, the schools are still separated for Croatian children and Serbian children. So our rule is to keep them together. So many workshops and everything that we do in our museum is always for both of these nationality. And during all this time, they enjoy everything what they do and how they understand the rule of museum. And when they found some drawing from 10 years old children, and it is written that Vukovar is a happy man with wooden heart, then they think that our rule is going in the right direction. And of course, for us it is very important that we teach them about the history, but not to teach them to be prisoner of the past, but to understand them that they can be prepared for the future. And we realized that we can do it, we can all do it, we can make our life better, but only if we living and building together. So I can tell you after these 25 years that I work in this museum that I'm very thankful for opportunity to be with my colleagues from my museum and from colleagues from many other museums, institutions and associations from all over Croatia to have a possibility and have a room to keep the memory and preserve the memory of the town of Vukovar after this war damaged, and also that I'm very proud to be part of this big family of musealists, conservators and many other institutions who from all over the world who keep the memory of whole civilization from the beginning until now. But in my experience and I believe in yours, we can do it all together if we living and building together. So, thank you.